Okay. Welcome to the 2017 spectacular that also we're going to talk about, John Miss. Welcome.
Welcome to Cowboy Bebop Cast. I'm your host.
I call Spike.
Shit!
Then I'm your host, Ed.
You know
with
what?
Me,
actually,
we've got
John,
Spike.
John, you can be Spike. I'll be Jet. Oh wait, no, fuck, you said Jet. Never mind. Fuck it, I'll be Spike.
We got our co-host Spike.
Bang.
Jet.
Hi.
And the fuck was her name?
Let's Faye. See if Ryan can remember
Faye?
Her name. Yeah, there you go.
Faye Valentine.
Faye Valentine.
I almost said my Valentine. I was like, no, that's Yu-Gi-Oh.
Get out of here.
And then you thought about my Shiranui and you're like, yes.
Then I thought about my Sharona. And then I thought
my
Karuba.
So, guys, we are in the future, but also in the past.
2016 is no longer here. It has officially gone to fuck itself.
Yeah, get out.
We welcome 2017 as our new overlord.
Yeah. There was a lot of good games last year. I'll say that.
There was also a lot of good games that was supposed to be released last year, but got postponed to this year.
Yeah. I'm looking at you, fucking Atlas.
Yeah, Atlas. Fuck. And BioWare.
Yeah. Wait, what did BioWare come out with?
And Mass Effect Andromeda was originally announced for December 2016.
Oh, that's not out yet?
No, yeah. It's coming out in a few months. It got postponed a few months.
Oh, okay. Because I know this one person who, her social media was all Mass Effect, and it was just driving me crazy.
Dude,
I like Mass Effect 1.
I would be all about having,
I just know you can
Spends
romance the aliens.
Oh, you
like,
can.
The weirdest aliens. You can romance
well,
them.
Well, I mean, as long as they're in your crew.
Finally.
Garrus.
Off.
I was all about romancing Garrus.
Apparently everyone was.
Dude, Garrus is a badass. And when you try to romance him, he's all awkward as fuck about it because he doesn't know how to go about being in a relationship with a human. So he, like, looks up instructional videos and shit. Like, cause, like, what is safe for a human is not safe for a Terran, or Terran, and vice versa.
Cool. Yeah, 2016 is behind us. We can focus on a whole new year. Hopefully, it's gonna be great. Let's take a look back at it, guys. But before we do that, who the fuck are you guys? Cause I just
we already introduced ourselves. I'm Ed, you're Spike, he's Jet, and she's Faye.
Are we gonna go with this? Are we gonna stick with the shtick? God damn it!
I didn't actually watch Cowboy Bebop, just so you know.
Oh,
I missed that period. Okay, I know it came back on Adult Swim a lot.
I mean,
but
I think it's still running to this day.
I would recommend taking a look at it. I've got it on Blu-ray actually.
Yeah, it's really
cool.
Good.
I bought it on Blu-ray because I went to a panel at an anime convention of Steve Bloom, and he said that the commentary for the Blu-ray of Cowboy Bebop is both funny and has some interesting information in it.
Oh, I like interesting and funny commentary.
Yes. Yeah. I've yet to actually watch it, though, because like I've seen the series so many times.
Yeah, it's one of the classics. It's just like that. Well, you've seen Gurren, so you've seen one of the many classics.
Yeah, I saw Gurren.
Schwarzenegger. It's a good anime too.
Great anime. Trigun's another classic.
Yeah.
If you, I recommend. If have you seen Trigun?
No.
I recommend that too.
Yeah, I know because Desiree is crazy about it.
Voice actor for Vash the Stampede is Johnny On Bosch, who is the Black the Ranger. Second Black Ranger in Power Rangers.
Oh yeah, yeah, I remember that. That's the thing. Like, I know the names and I know the people, but I've never actually seen the shows.
I definitely recommend it. It's definitely a classic.
Yeah. Yeah. Aside from our monikers that we use in space.
Yes, I'm Silverfist 91, also known as Ryan.
I'm Tom Hypester, also known as Tom Hipster. As Lieutenant Edley incorrectly said.
As
but
Little Teddy.
Yeah, Little Teddy.
Incorrectly likes said. To call you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm Mama Donovan. I'm the Texas Steampunk Holdra. And I can't hear John right now.
I don't think John is working right now.
Is John asleep?
Nope, he's right there.
Oh, there you are.
My computer went out, sorry.
Technical difficulties, perhaps. Oh my god, and there's a crying baby downstairs.
Oh no. There's a crying
myself
baby.
Myself while that's happening for a bit, so you all go about.
Okay.
What I miss?
John Ryan has another person in his basement, but don't worry about that. Yeah. So 2016, it was a year, but it was a good year for, I guess, media when it comes to the mass media, including video games, movies, anime, and the sort. We're not going to really focus on a lot of the big events. You know the big events of 2016 that made it a shit year, but regardless, we're just going to focus on more the media and entertainment part side of it.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to kind of say what our top, I don't know, maybe three things were in every, not every category, but in a couple of them. And get into our weeks, I guess.
Okay.
That sound, yeah.
Do you want to start with our weeks first, I guess?
Yeah.
I worked most of the week, and then I partied on New Year's Eve.
Okay. Thank you, Tom.
That's Ryan.
I know. I said Tom.
I guess for Johnmas, my family went over to celebrate a pagan holiday. I didn't really get into that celebration, because I really wanted to celebrate Johnmas.
Well, yeah, that's right. It actually has been a couple weeks since.
Yeah.
Because somebody forgot to upload two weeks ago.
Some asshole.
I wonder who that was.
Some fucking loser
really
editor.
Talk to that guy.
Some loser editor that's totally getting fired.
I know, we totally need to give him the sack.
Yeah, kind of a dick too.
I'll give him the sack, all right.
Oh yeah, finally.
Goodness.
But yeah, how was your Johnmas, Ryan?
Oh well, I worked most of it.
Huh.
But when I didn't work, I just hanging out, really.
Yeah. Do we hang out? Do we do the Skype thing, or was it did I just knock out? I think I played Overwatch.
Me and John
for a
were
bit.
Definitely hanging out.
Yeah, I think I did go to sleep. I was pissed off. I had a very bad Johnmas.
Oh,
family.
No.
Yeah, just personal stuff, but it's just like, eh, whatever. I ended up just playing a bunch of Overwatch and going to sleep. But for New Year's, just did the whole... My sister came over, so that's really a good thing. My sisters are really like the people that kind of get me the most. and we ended
one?
Up... God damn it, Ryan. I hate you. I'm not gonna comment on that.
Yeah, we've always liked me.
Yeah, one of them's a fucking Fujoshi.
Fujoshi.
It's the lady otaku. But we ended up playing Jackbox. I got my family into Jackbox, so that was really cool.
Real good.
Yeah, they were like, "Oh my god, you can play on your phone." I was like, "Yeah, all you got to do is enter code.
Pretty
I don't
magical.
Have to download anything." It's like, "Yeah, you don't have to download anything." And they just like their minds explode out of their ass, and I was like, "Okay." Cool. I finally found a game that my family would want to play with me. It's like, hey guys, you want to just play like, you know, 10 rounds of comp? Just do our placement matches, you know, see if we get silver.
You don't even want to do 10 rounds of comp.
That's true. But
you get like one in and you're like, fuck this noise.
Yeah, I'm like, eh, I don't want to do this. I kind of don't want to get yelled at, so. Aside from that, like, games, I've been still enjoying Watch Dogs 2. That game is really fucking fun. When I finish it, I'll probably give, like, a little review about it, but I'm not sure. And then I started Final Fantasy 15 today, today that we're recording is New Year's Day, so I did it at, like, 12 in the morning. My sister's like, why don't we just play Final Fantasy? I was like, yeah, sure. And she had never seen it, and she was just like, why does this game look so fucking good? And I was like, we started playing, and then she just like was in amazement of it. It's like, oh man, it's awesome. And then started playing Stand By Me, and I was like, okay, all right. aside from that, it's just like, that's it. Worked, cried, you know, the usual.
I'm crying.
What about you? Tor John.
Tori, how was your week?
Mine was pretty good. So Christmas was great. Like, my family came
sorry,
over.
Sorry, what?
I'm sorry. John Miss.
John Miss was great. He's fired. He's fired, Ryan.
Oh, God. Unprofessionalism. Continue.
Okay, so my John Miss went great. My family came over because we were hosting. And my uncle made some really great, like, ribeye steak for the lunch, and it was so good. But that was in the morning, afternoon. I got to hang out with my family, and I got some great gifts. First of all, I got a present from Ryan. He gave me my Bucky.
I was gonna say it wasn't his dick this time because he's in Wisconsin.
No, it's my Bucky.
Is that going in the HR report?
No.
Nah, not this time. Okay, so I got the Bucky figure from Ryan, which I love. It's on my, it's not on the main shelf, it's on the side shelf, like with my books. It's great. And I also got a bunch of gift cards from my parents and just a few things that I needed, like shirts and a new makeup bag, you know, just grown-up stuff. Oh, and I also got Batman versus Superman, the Ultimate Edition. So I can finally... What?
You can throw that away in the garbage?
No!
I mean...
No, it's got Wonder Woman in it, so I want it. It's mine.
It has Wonder Woman for like 5 minutes, and that's it.
I know, and that's worth every penny. Even if it had like a split second of Wonder Woman, I'd be like, oh, my queen! I must have her.
You could like get one of the animated DC movies.
Those are
really good and have the worthy amount of Wonder Woman in it.
Mm-hmm.
Which is not less than 5 minutes.
But yeah, and then on Johnmas night, I went to go to my friend's house because she's in town. She was on leave from the army, and so we watched just a buttload of movies over the next few days. But, like, the main one we watched, we had a Spidey pool night on Johnmas.
Good night.
Mm-hmm. Like, okay, we'd watched the Spider-Man, like, the Amazing Spider-Man, the Andrew Garfield one last time she got here. So this time we watched the second one, we watched Deadpool, and then we watched Civil War. And just added our fangirl commentary to it all as we got drunk.
I watched Civil War recently, too. I actually got around to watching it. Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing. Now it's not just me who's like fangirling all over it. Well, granted. Okay, how did you like it?
It was good. That didn't feel like a Captain America movie. It felt like Avengers movie.
It felt like an Avengers movie, especially the part of Avengers where we focus on Tony too much.
Yeah.
It's like we could focus on everyone's problem, but no, let's go back to Tony's daddy issues for like the fifth time.
Yeah, except this time, his mom. It's just the Uncle Ben situation. Are we going to show Uncle Ben dying?
It's like almost like Spider-Man 3, where it shows the villain, the person who killed Uncle Ben.
Mm-hmm.
It happened in this one. Oh my god.
I'm sorry.
They showed the person who killed Papa Stark.
Can we just like stop fawning over like I'm tired of seeing the Waynes dying. I'm tired of seeing.
I know that's happened. People complain about Uncle Ben dying. The Waynes have died like 20 times.
If the new Spider-Man movie can just start off not having Uncle Ben dying, like he's already dead.
I bet. Okay, this is my $20 that there is going to be at least one scene of a flashback with Uncle Ben.
Well, I mean, I'd imagine there's going to be like a callback or like. If there's a flashback, it's not going to be long.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully, it's just like showing Uncle Ben,
or maybe
like, you know,
like it'll
give him
show,
his wisdom.
It'll show like hot Aunt May. By the way, Aunt May.
More like Aunt Bay.
More like Aunt Bay. Like, damn.
She shouldn't be that hot.
Has no right being that fucking smoking hot.
I don't get
which
it.
They address that in the movie. Like, Tony's all like, dude, I can't believe she's someone's aunt. Like,
I don't give a shit.
And he's like, even like, it's like, come with me to Germany or I'll tell Aunt Hottie.
It's like Robert Downey Jr. like walked on the set and saw her and goes, wait, you're Aunt May? Oh, yeah.
It's like, I remember you.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They worked together before, didn't they? The two actors.
They were a couple in a movie.
No, Aunt Bay is fantastic, but what I'd like to see is maybe like have Aunt May sit Peter down and like reference, like, I know it's been rough since Uncle Ben died, and like that's about it. That's where I'm hoping, like, that's the extent they'd reach.
Also, a picture, because I do want to visualize
like,
a young Uncle Ben,
like very.
No,
suave
I want him to be the oldest looking crustacean fuck because of the comparison.
I want a young spry looking picture of Uncle Ben, and like Aunt May just looks at it and goes,
Can he be black, please?
No, well, I mean, he could.
Yeah, it could. It wouldn't affect Peter
Miles
at all.
Morales movie win.
I was about to say, it's like, only if we have a black Spider-Man as well.
He's the best Spider-Man next to punk rock Spider-Man.
There's a punk rock Spider-Man?
Punk rock Spider-Man is shit tier.
Fuck you, he's cool.
What about Doc Ock Spider-Man?
What about Spider-Gwen? What about Gwenpool?
Gwenpool's actually a lot better.
Gwenpool's garbage, Spider-Gwen's garbage.
You think Deadpool's garbage and Marvel's garbage, so why are we taking your advice, John?
No, I don't think Marvel's garbage. I think most of Marvel's garbage, because Spider-Man.
Spider-Man and Deadpool are really the only standoffs that I really like.
We just established that most comic books are just bad.
No.
That's true. Most comic books are bad, though.
There's so many comic books out there that most of them are bad.
Yeah.
But that means, like, of the 90, if 90% of them are bad and only 10% of them are good, that's already, like, thousands that are good. Yeah. It's like, no, only 20,000 are good.
Out of, only 20,000 out of the 100,000.
I guess that one time Punisher was black counts as a good one.
And guess what? That 20,000 has limited printings. Good luck.
True. Oh, that was going to be one of my good things in the year. That I get to meet the Punisher.
Oh, yeah.
He punished your...
I mean, he didn't do that, but he did call me Mama. He did call me Mama.
Ew.
Like,
not
in that casual
mama.
Sense. Like, hey, Mama, how you doing?
Not the Mama.
I imagine Punisher doing that. Just,
not the Mama. Mama.
Not the Mama.
What? No, that happened.
Wait, Was Murdoch in the same room? Matt Murdoch?
No, he didn't, because he didn't... No, because this was during the photo ops, and he wasn't there. So this wasn't during the panel.
I would have loved it if, like Punisher guy called you Mama, and then just Matt Murdoch guy just goes, not
Charlie
to Mama.
Cox, yeah.
Not to Mama.
Well, he's British. So
not
like,
the mama.
Why are you calling her mum?
Not the mummy.
That's an American thing.
Not the mummy.
Are you my mummy?
Oh, oh, God. Well, that took a dark turn.
What?
Are you my mum?
Now you wretched sea urchin.
No, Doctor Who. God damn it.
What's a Doctor Who?
Dr. Jew.
John, moving again, on. We're at it. You're at a 9, and then we just kick it up to 32.
Exactly.
Moving on. What were we talking about? Civil War. Oh, yeah, we're Tori's still talking about her week. We get so sidetracked.
Thank you, Tori.
Hey, it was me who just went things overboard. Please give me credit where credit is due.
Okay, so after I got to hang out with my friend, let's see, we watched 20 movies in 3 days. Mm-hmm. It was intense.
Oh.
But then I had New Year's with my friend Hannah. And normally what we do every year is we pick something from Pinterest to try to recreate, but it never turns out right. Well, this year it actually turned out okay. We just, like, painted some animals and painted a canvas, and we glued the animals onto the canvas, and it worked out. Because before we tried to make a balloon fort, like a balloon castle. What? And what we ended up doing was making a string of balloons. We blew up, like, 150 balloons.
What? Nope.
Oh, it was really rough on my throat those days.
Oh, a lot of things. Okay, never mind.
Okay, so the first time we tried to make a balloon castle, and we just ended up making a string of balloons and putting them over a cardboard box and being like, yay, balloon castle, we did it.
How much alcohol did you consume?
None.
Oh, God.
That was before I was legal.
Oh. Well,
I mean, that's no excuse.
Say. 18-year-old me has something to say to you then.
Okay. And then the year after that, we tried to make mug cakes, where you just, like, make chocolate cake in a mug. That failed spectacularly. It tasted disgusting.
God, I hate it when people do that. Like, just do that. It's like, oh, it makes it more moist. It's like, no, you're, like, shooting it up with radiation in there. That's not how cakes are supposed to be fucking made.
It was just, like, flour and milk. It was disgusting.
It's gross.
Tori,
and then
because
what?
When you do it in a mug, you're not fully baking it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I learned.
The more you know.
Look, she was young and impressionable.
And
you
then
know,
I could definitely make
a sexist joke, but I will not.
Go on, Tori.
Okay, so and last year, I think you got okay. John remembers last year because last year we tried to make one of those rainbow cakes.
Oh yeah. I saw that fucking nightmare.
Oh, I remember that. Oh, my God.
And we tried to put the Alamo on it. There's just a mess of pink and M&Ms and gummy bears.
I remember looking at this and be like, is this what the Alamo is like, guys?
Remember the Alamo.
I mean, wait. I'm not from Texas. I don't know. Is this the Alamo?
Time out. Ryan, did you ever see the Alamo while you were in San Antonio?
No.
I was about to ask.
What the fuck?
Oh, come on. It was so close to the
John,
convention center.
John, you never took me there, all right?
We're taking you to the Alamo.
Cool.
John, what the fuck is wrong with you?
It's like 5 minutes away from the
convention
center.
Dude, you didn't take me to Whataburger till the last fucking day.
Because you have to savor Whataburger while you're
on the... No, you don't. No, you don't. You eat it all 3 days when you're there.
I want Whataburger every day of my life.
You eat it for every meal.
I will buy you Whataburger one of those days, my friend.
Thank you.
As soon as I get there, we are going to Whataburger.
Like, we're just going to have a buffet of Whataburger. Just, like, trays filled with burgers and the chicken and the... fries and the honey butter chicken biscuits.
I'm seeing some awesome news on Facebook right now. This just in. Betty White made it.
Oh, okay.
Well, duh.
She survived 2016.
I mean, so did Stan Lee.
Did you guys hear that, like, someone actually put up, like, a GoFundMe or a Kickstarter or something of, like,
I know,
protecting Betty White?
Yeah, awesome. I saw that,
and
I was like,
and it got a good, it got a good amount of money within the first day.
What are they supposed to do with the money, though?
Like, hire a bodyguard.
Also,
that's not
Tori,
what killed people.
Tori,
what?
I'm looking at your cake right now. What the fuck?
Okay, so
you give Texas, you give Texas shame more than it is.
God, well, yeah, it's supposed to fail. So, yeah, that was a fail. Instagram fail, for real.
Where's this cake at? Where's the image of this cake?
John, you saw it.
It's in her uploads. Facebook from last year.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me.
This year has turned out pretty well. Although, you're supposed to cut the animals in half and then glue them to the canvas, but you know, we just didn't do that. So, but it still came out kind of well. So we're like, it's okay. The Pinterest thing was mostly a success. It was just the year that was a total failure. So one thing had to succeed this year. And it definitely, okay, this is getting topical. This is definitely not Mariah Carey, because we were watching that New Year's Rockin' Eve, and she just barely performed at all. Like, and they were leading up to it too. They're like, oh, Mariah Carey performing tonight. And she was like lip syncing through one of her songs. Well, like, whoa, obviously. But she's also like, okay, we didn't sound check the song. So she's just walking around, not even singing.
Oh, Mariah Carey, like, being shit? Get the fuck out of town.
When did she
A reason why she's not relevant anymore at all.
Was she ever?
Kind of.
Yeah, in the 90s. But that was, that was 20 years ago, so.
She was running in the 90s, right? Just run it. No? Okay. I'm just going to go over here to my,
I don't remember
my corner.
I don't remember any Mariah Carey songs.
I had a Christmas album. I'll admit that.
Why?
Because I don't know. Because fuck you, John. I was like six when that came out. Just go fuck yourself, John.
What does everything have to involve me fucking myself?
Oh, it's a common thing that you do.
Tori, anything else for you?
John cries.
Nope. I got my presents. I got to watch a whole bunch of movies with my friend. Got drunk and also, you know, did my Pinterest thing for New Year's. So far it's been good.
Nice.
Cool beans.
Mr. John, what did you do for your Johnmas and New Year's?
New John.
I worked.
New John. Oh.
I worked. That's really all I did. I haven't had a day off since my birthday.
Anime, video games, nothing?
I haven't had a day off.
Oh.
Since my birthday.
Oh, that's another thing. Kiss Him, Not Me finished. And it only got... I know that the manga is still ongoing, but, like, it only got the most sensible conclusion you could get. Like, it was kind of predictable, but, like, it's really the only really realistic ending.
So, did it end, or did the season end?
The season ended, but okay. I don't know about a season two.
It might happen if it's popular.
It might happen, because... it was really good, and a lot of people like it.
She fucked one of the boys. That's
no, that's not what happened. It was kind of funny, because, okay, the final episode is basically everyone tells her, everyone actually confesses, say, we like you, and we want to go out with you, so choose one of us. You don't have to decide now. We'll give you time to decide.
Don't and tell so me. I want to finish this.
Oh, okay, fine.
I will do it next week.
We'll talk about it next week.
Yeah.
But, like, it's so me. It's what I would do.
Jeez. Oh, I can only imagine.
She'd say yes to every boy and fuck him. Okay.
There you go. But, okay. Well, John, now that I can transition into that, I can't. So, guys, what is our favorite things? Media, movies, games.
What's your favorite anime of this?
Oh, God.
Of the year, my favorite anime?
Oh, yeah. Sweetness and Lightning.
Okay.
I really love that anime.
In the last few weeks, JoJo ended. The season ended for JoJo. It's good. It's a good ending.
I mean, JoJo's good. That kid fucking is the hero of JoJo.
Right? Dude, like, I don't know. Anime, like, I can't think of anything offhand, but I don't find anything... it might be just the recent season of JoJo might have been my favorite anime this year.
I think Pat said it the best. He says his headcanon is that kid just joins the Speedwagon Foundation.
He becomes the new CEO of the Speedwagon Foundation.
Yeah, it's like, okay, I can live with that.
Right. let's see, Tiger Mask was good.
The
it's not over yet.
It's not over yet.
It's not over.
You know what? Let me ask you a question on the topic of JoJo. Sorry to be a side segue.
No, that's fine.
But whatever happened to Achtung Baby?
Achtung Baby?
Didn't they give it over to Speedwagon?
Yeah, Jotaro adopts her.
Huh. Yeah, but then what happens after that? Because I feel like that's
Okay, who's the guy that saved Josuke's mom and him? I don't fucking know.
Oh yeah, they just never explain it. It's just a guy who has that hair.
I just
thought like, oh, does like fucking Josuke go into the past and save himself? Because that silhouette looks just like Jotaro.
None of that shit happens. It's just mystery, man.
Okay, Ryan. So, what's your favorite anime of the year?
Drifters was pretty good. Yuri on Ice was pretty good.
Gay Boys on Ice.
Hey,
Essentially.
Yuri on Ice was pretty good. I know this is an old anime, but I watched it this year. I watched Gunbusters, and Gunbusters is fucking Gunbusters, so it's good.
What was going on earlier this year?
I mean, I just watched a lot of old stuff. Lupin the Third was fucking great.
I don't remember anything going on earlier this year that stood out.
Bubuki Brinky ended, but that was
What about My Hero Academia? You were all over that shit.
Oh,
yeah, it's good, but the thing is that like I said in that big rant, it was just a really disappointing ending.
It was.
I have not yet read the manga yet because I haven't had time. I know I should have had time in the fucking 6 months I was laid off, but nonetheless, I didn't.
Okay.
Yeah, I think at the time I was watching that and Lupin, so Lupin consumed a lot of my time. Lupin the Third is fucking good. It's a good ass old anime. If you like old anime, watch Lupin the Third. I think the worst anime for me this year has got to be Osomatsu-san. That anime is literally Osomatsu.
Yeah, that was one of the worst ones.
I really hate that anime. It's not funny. I get it's an old anime and it has some of those old tropes, but even old anime is not that bad.
I think my favorite of this year, and I'm gonna go out of left field, was Erased.
I still need to watch that.
Erased?
It's actually really good.
You keep telling me about that, but I never had a chance to sit down and watch it.
You don't listen to the shit I watch.
Dude, you know how long my anime list is?
We'll make it shorter.
That's one of the goals is to watch a new series every 2 weeks. Finish a new series every 2 weeks. So, come back to me on that. Hold me on that podcast.
My favorite anime would probably be the recent season of JoJo.
Yeah, JoJo's good.
JoJo's my number two slot, only reason it's number two.
Space Patrol Luluco. That was a good one, too, that came out this year.
Luluco's into my top five. Luluco's top five.
Kiznever came out this year.
Kiznever's not in my top five. I felt like it was too much buildup, but overall disappointment.
Really need to finish that too. I've been disappointing myself with this year.
It's in the top 10, but not top 5.
Yeah.
Worst animes though for this year.
Berserk. I'll agree on that.
I was gonna say Berserk. That was the worst, one of the worst ones of this year.
Yeah. I mean, White Casca, the Blu-ray versions. The Blu-ray versions actually making the anime better. Go fuck yourself, man. It's come on.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
And the fact that they miss an entire arc, the beginning arc, it's like, let's just eat a dick.
Oh dear.
The other worst one was The Lost Village, which was supposed to be good, but it just shat itself.
Wasn't that one where like people go on the bus and they all go there? They have like different stories and shit like that.
They go on the bus because they want to go to this forest, this village in the middle of nowhere where apparently you can start your life all over again.
Yeah.
The village has like a psychological effect where it manifests people's inner fears, and then it shits itself in the end.
That's disappointing because I was actually looking forward to watching that.
Oh, and also fuck Magical Girl Racing Project. That's
serious. I know, because I was thinking, I was like, wasn't there that like Magical Girl Project thingy that was also really bad?
It's really bad. Yeah, I agree with that.
Fuck that series.
Glasses, popular guy.
Sakamoto. That's Sakamoto. Number 3.
Yeah, Sakamoto is really good.
91 Days is number 4 for this year.
I haven't seen that yet.
Oh, fuck. You know what I just realized? That's a really good one, too.
Is that Boku no Stray Dogs as well?
Bungo no Stray Dogs? I didn't see that one.
Is that in the same kind of franchise? Because it looks like it has the same kind of art style.
I didn't see it. You know what?
Stray Dogs,
wasn't
the same guy? People.
It kind of looks like the same style. That's why I ask.
You know what? I got to put up there too. Mob Psycho 100.
No, that goes in the garbage tier for me.
It is a great series.
And the English dub can go even more in the garbage.
Yeah.
It can go underneath the gunpla, not right next to it.
You know what? I will say this: 2016 was a good year for anime.
It was.
Yeah, anime and games.
What about Keijo?
Keijo was really good.
Keijo was all right. Like, the only problem with Keijo, it took itself too seriously.
It's a good anime to turn your brain off.
Like, it's silly. It's about, like, women. It's about women, like, knocking each other off platforms with their boobs and butts, but then it takes itself too seriously.
Oh, and, special.
And I'm like, it doesn't need to be this serious about itself. Like, it can go back to being silly.
Special nominee for worst anime, Japan, for not releasing the fucking Koe no Katachi movie in America. Go fuck yourself, Japan.
No, because Japan's going to fight back, and I'm not going to finish that sentence.
Nope, don't. Please don't. Koe no Katachi is should be released in the US. That's a fucking good manga, if no one's ever read it. I'm surprised John even read it.
Fuck you, I love that story.
It's so good. Oh, it made me cry.
I want to follow up with another fuck you to Japan. Fuck you for Dragon Ball Super. That series was shit.
Yeah. It's a slice of life, Dragon Ball.
You know, I hear, like, positive and negative things. Like, people saying it's good, people saying it's bad. And like,
it's okay if you really like Dragon Ball, but it's bad if you really like Dragon Ball.
I will fight anybody who tells me I'm wrong about Dragon Ball. I will fight you physically.
Okay.
Yeah, I was never a big fan of it, so I was like, I just kind of turned the other way. Oh, Cabinet of the Iron Fortress came out this year. If you haven't seen that, that's really good as well.
I never got a chance to see it.
Came out the same time as Kids Never and Sakamoto, so it was go up against a lot of competition.
All right, let's move on to movies now.
Yeah, because we'll talk about anime.
Let's talk
the rest
about
of this fucking
favorite
anime
movie
thing
that you've seen releasing this year. Okay. I already know my pick. And it's in theaters.
I'll get back on that one.
Ryan, what's your best movie?
Not me first.
Okay. Tom.
I didn't see that many movies, so I really don't have an answer for you.
Pick one then. Pick one of the few movies you've seen.
I don't know. Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. So it was all right.
I still want to see that because I like Eddie Redmayne.
It's a good movie. I didn't finish my thought the last time, but I mean, if you like Harry Potter, it's good.
Ryan, I'm gonna bet $20 I can pick out the movie you think was the best.
Okay.
Let me see what movies came out.
Ryan, was it Deadpool?
No. Deadpool didn't come out this year.
Okay, Deadpool
that was last year. Wasn't
last
it?
Year, you're
cool.
Sure?
No, it came out
2015.
It came out this year.
Well, in theaters.
Because I saw it with my ex on Valentine's Day. I remember that.
It came out 2016.
So yeah, Deadpool's gonna be mine then, yeah.
Oh wow. No, but it felt like so long ago.
Okay.
I saw 10 Cloverfield Lane too.
Oh wow. It came out like super early.
Yeah.
Yeah, it came out in February. Valentine's it came Day. Out before my birthday.
I'm not fucking wrong. Fuck you guys.
It came out a few days before my birthday. Even no, then, I, no, it's not my favorite. No.
I agreed with you, John. I remember it came out.
Yeah. Okay, Ryan, what is your favorite movie? I really want to know because I want to pick
Doctor Strange.
Kung Fu Panda 3. Oh.
No, I know. Yeah. I know Ryan's movie. I know Ryan's movie.
I already
ready?
Said it.
You said it right now.
I just said it, John.
What was it?
Doctor Strange.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Sausage Party because of Seth Rogen.
I did not watch that movie.
Oh, no.
But someone did.
I really want to see Moonlight. I think that was... Everyone said
that's
really
good. Oh, is that the one with the... Mahasuara Ali?
Yeah.
Oh, I wanted to see that too, because it looks like Oscar baity, and I like to watch the Oscar bait movies before the Oscars.
I'm not. Anyways.
But yeah, Doctor Strange was my favorite movie of the year.
Mine's gonna be then. I changed mine to Deadpool then, because that was honestly it got me to not see any more Marvel movies because of it.
Really? Are we all gonna have a Marvel movie? Like each have a different Marvel movie as our favorite this year?
I mean, that's mine because it's like I don't really give a shit about Doctor Strange. I don't give a shit about anything else. Deadpool was just number one for me.
Because that means mine's Civil War.
Oh, well, you're
wrong. That came out at the beginning of the year, right?
It came out in May.
Oh, May. Oh, John, I know what yours is. Utopia. There you go. There's no need.
Fuck you.
So, favorite video game?
No. You're not going to put that evil on me. How dare
okay,
you?
Okay. Batman v Superman. I know.
No.
Suicide Squad. It's calling you, John.
No. See, I'm a little biased to say that Rogue One was my favorite movie.
Okay, that's cool.
I kind of want to watch it.
Go ahead.
No, go. I just said I kind of want to watch that.
It's really, you need to watch it.
I kind of want to watch it because I'll tell you my disappointing movie this year.
Yeah, I went to go see that a second time because my friend Hannah hadn't seen it. And it's better the second time because all the details of the story that you missed the first time around, easier to catch the second time. And it flows better.
What?
But I got.
What are you talking about? I got distracted. Sorry.
I'm talking about Rogue One.
Oh.
I got to say that also that Magnificent Seven was pretty good.
All right. I kind of wanted. It's a Tarantino flick, right?
No, it's not a Tarantino flick.
Magnificent Seven.
It's Tarantino-esque, but it's about seven.
That's Hateful Eight.
No, Magnificent Seven is Tarantino-esque.
Oh yeah, that's the Denzel Washington. Denzel Washington, Chris Pratt. I've okay. wanted to watch that one.
It's the remake of the old western based on Seven Samurai.
Okay, worst movie of the year.
Do you really want to hear mine? Because everyone's gonna get pissed when I said.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Go.
So when I broke up with Max, me and her wanted to watch all these movies together because I wanted to get more into her movies. Uh-huh. And so I bought all of them, and I was like, okay. Well, she's gone, whatever. I'll just watch them by myself. And I watched all the Star Wars. And I have to say, I was really let down by the films. But making up for it, I do love the setting. I love everything about the setting of Star Wars. But I feel like those movies, to me, coming from my view, is like I've never seen a single one of these Star Wars movies. And throughout my life, I've seen references, I've seen spoofs, I've seen everything under the planet about Star Wars except for Star Wars. So building up this hype, building up all this like, oh my God, Tom, like fucking go watch these movies. These are like the greatest movies man has ever made. And I watch them and, you know, the effects are great. The practical effects are great in the original trilogy. But like, I don't see the reason why people get so hyped for this. And then I started watching recently, which I didn't mention, is Star Wars The Clone Wars series. And now I understand why people love this setting of Star Wars so much. Because Star Wars The Clone Wars series like fixes all the problems I have with Star Wars. So I'll say that for me, the Star Wars movies are disappointing. And they were my disappointing movie for the year because of all that. I said, like, there's just so much hype. There's so much garnish over this. There's so much love for this. That I, you know, got told if I didn't like this, I'm a jaded fucking person. It's like, I just, you know, I didn't like it. I didn't like the whole Luke and Leia and the whole, like, Skywalker family saga kind of thing, you know? I love hearing side stories. I loved hearing about how, in the Clone Wars series, how Obi-Wan fucking struggles with getting revenge on Darth Maul the whole series. And Darth Maul's like, yeah, I'm fucking, like, give me your revenge, like, you know? Let that hate build and all that stuff. And he's fucking loving it. And I love how they make Anakin, you know, a real fucking character instead of like a whiny bitch the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like everything about that, you know, and about the side stories and about like, I love the Star Wars games. Like I loved, what's that fucking game?
Knights of the Old Republic.
Yeah. I love KOTOR and I love,
those are great games.
What is it? What's that fucking game?
Knights of the Old Republic 2?
Battlefield.
No, well, that's
Battlefront.
Good. Battlefront, right.
God damn it. With Darth Vader clone guy, and he's like Star-Lord, Star-Killer.
Oh, Force Unleashed.
Force Unleashed,
he wasn't
yeah.
a clone, he was his apprentice. But
apprentice, yeah, sorry.
Doesn't matter, the story was stupid.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, I like that setting, so rip into me if you want, but that's my disappointing film of the year.
I mean, the prequels were shit. I don't think anyone will argue with that.
I still like the prequels. Because, well, they came out when I was a kid.
They came out when I was a kid, too, and I still think they're shit.
I just watched them with major nostalgia goggles.
If you watch The Clone Wars, I think you'll have,
I watched
like,
it as a kid and thought the second episode 2 was boring as
No. The Clone Wars TV show.
Oh, I don't like the idea of clones.
Yeah, but it's a good TV show.
The entire idea of clones, I just do not care for.
You can literally, like, go watch Cosmonaut Gaming. He did a whole write-up on why you should watch the show, and it fixes all a lot of this shit in it.
Nah,
trust
I'm
me.
Good.
Okay.
Well, it kind of ruins my like why I should care about these guys, because they're actually just like rapidly aged clones of the same person, and they're all the same guy.
I mean, like that's the main focus.
It gives less worth to like the soldiers that are fighting these wars. It's just like, okay, a bunch of these guys died. Oh well, we can just get a bunch more from the vets. Whereas in like stormtroopers were people, so they've got a little bit more meaning behind them.
I also
It's Rogue One. The stormtroopers in Rogue One were the worst pieces of shit I've ever seen in any movie.
I can't wait to watch that then.
Oh man,
because I did enjoy Episode 7. I will say that out of all those movies, I really did Episode 7.
I loved Episode 7. Like when the podcast did a spoiler cast on Episode 7 last year, like. Everyone else was all like, nah, this movie wasn't that great. And I was the one that was going like, I absolutely love this movie. Like, I came in wanting to love this movie, and I walked out loving this movie. That being said,
I liked it too. It wasn't just you.
You liked it. I loved it. Like, I was all aboard, like, the entirety of the movie from start to finish. Like, I honestly didn't think it was, like, overly flawed. Or it was like, oh, this and that. Nah. Oh,
yeah,
great.
It had a balance of a lot of good stuff, and you know there was some bad parts, but you know it fucking made up for
it. Didn't have any
whole
bad parts. I thought it was all good. Like I fucking was 100% in it the entire way through.
I just felt like
that being said, I was disappointed in Rogue One. That's gonna be my pick for this year. Of it, I don't think it's a bad movie. I just think it was disappointing.
The same way I feel about the Star Wars movies in general. It's not... You liked it, but it's like it wasn't really lived up to your standards. Live up to your standards coming up out of 7, right?
No, well, it's not even that. It's just like... Well, yeah, it didn't live up to those standards, but then I just lowered my standards a bit and just went to like basic storytelling, and it even failed on that front.
Hmm.
Like, the lack of character development for all of the characters, that you'd know exactly how the movie's gonna end if you're at all familiar with the Star Wars universe.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, like, those side stories have always really... It's going to Marvel, too, where I like side stories a lot more than the actual in-universe stuff. Like, I'm really sick and tired of... And that's why I felt so disappointed with I was gonna say Wizards of Waverly Place, Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Is that it's like, hey, we're gonna connect this to Star Wars. I mean, to Harry Potter now. Get ready, because we are going to connect to Harry Potter now. Big movie trilogy coming. Money, money, money. It's like, can it just be its own thing? Can we just have its own thing? No, okay, I guess not. But I don't know. Tori, what was your most disappointing movie?
Okay, so there is... Okay, I'm actually disappointed in this indie movie I was looking forward to. It's called The Curse of Sleeping Beauty. And when I saw the trailer for it, the sets look cool. It was... Granted, the concept, I could tell, was really... It's like dark fairy tale setting. But I like dark fairy tale setting.
And it's like, about like... What the hell, like Brothers Grimm, is that what it's called? Like the original fairy tale, like how the original fairy tale stories were grimdark.
Yeah, kind of like that. Although this one, like the guy has been having nightmares about this Sleeping Beauty, who's just kind of like an Aurora figure, who's always like, come and save me. And it shows that the real her is trapped in, like, some dark laboratory, so he has to find her. So I'm like, oh, this sounds pretty interesting. It wasn't interesting at all. It was boring.
You told me this, and I thought, the first thing I thought was, like, that sounds so fucking lame.
Sounds edgy.
He had a dream about this woman, and she wants you to save her, and then she's in his laboratory, God save her. Wow, that sounds the worst.
Snow White Ravenclaw.
Even that, I was expecting like more creative, because it was kind of a horror movie, but I was expecting more creative.
What was this
creature
movie titled
something
again?
More fair? The Curse of Sleeping Beauty.
You expected creativity from something titled The Curse of Sleeping Beauty?
I was literally about to say that.
Like, the costumes look nice and the sets look nice, but the monsters were literally just mannequins.
Oh.
It was that mannequin horror where, turn around, the mannequin has moved closer.
Wait, and, God. I thought this was the chick from Mean Girls for a second.
What?
The one who can tell weather with her boobs.
Lohan?
No, the chick who can tell weather with her boobs.
Tell weather with her boobs?
Yeah, you don't remember from...
I didn't watch that movie. Why would I?
What the fuck?
Karen?
It's a good movie.
Played by, what's her name? Amanda... Seyfried. Yeah, Amanda Seyfried.
I thought it was her for a second.
Well, it's not her. She'd be way too expensive.
How did she tell weather with her boobs? Does she feel them up? Does she get other people to feel them up?
Watch the movie.
Why?
It's actually kind of good. It's you know what? I'll say it's good. Yeah, I'll say it's good in that, like, it's a cheesy kind of movie. It's a cheesy bad kind of, I guess. I don't know. I wouldn't call it bad, though.
Yeah, it's good.
Teen favorite.
It's a teen favorite now. It's a teen classic.
Tina Fey and what's her face? Amy Poehler, I think, wrote it side by side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's based off of, like, a parenting book of all
things. Queen Bee. Queen Bee is the book that it was based off of.
Exactly.
Don't ask how I know that. I didn't watch the movie like 5 times and then watch it with a commentary. Oh no.
Big reveals.
Oh no. Tom is actually secret. The no secret. Tom has shit taste.
But yeah, okay. So basically, I knew that this Curse of Sleeping Beauty movie was going to be like, I knew it was going to be stupid, but I didn't expect it to be so boring. I wanted to see the stupid, and it wasn't stupid enough. It was just
it wasn't
boring.
Jupiter Ascending stupid.
It wasn't Jupiter Ascending stupid. Jupiter Ascending had some very strange moments and, like, you know, memorable moments, and had Eddie Redmayne, who, granted, his character is, like, crazy, but I loved it.
But did you fuck a furry?
Wait, what the fuck? Wait, hold on. What is this thing on her head? What? Tori, explain this to me. What the fuck is this?
Oh, that's the... Okay, that's
what
part
the
of the...
fuck? What is this?
I think that's
some,
actually
like...
the cage.
Cage? What cage?
That is like some avant-garde Hellraiser bullshit.
Wait,
right here.
Exactly.
Is this... Hold on. Is this the thing that she's fucking sleeping in? Like, when she's like... What?
Yep.
Oh my god. Yeah, now I know why this is your disappointing movie. Oh my god.
I can also see why she started to watch the movie to begin with.
Yeah. This is
Tori. Were you expecting this to be a guilty pleasure, Tori?
Yes.
And then it was just ended up being bad instead of like...
Yeah, it ended up being boring. It wasn't even a pleasure. I was expecting a guilty pleasure and
out of
nothing.
Context. I'm going to cut that out.
No, keep it in.
No, I meant I'm going to take that clip and copy paste it and take it out of context in so many ways.
That's Tori's. That's when Tori calls you. That's her ringtone, right?
Sure.
I don't even have his name.
Not even any pleasure.
This movie looks terrible.
It does.
It isn't even fun. It is, but it isn't even fun. Terrible.
Okay.
So Ryan, what was your disappointment of the year?
I already said it was Rogue One.
You said Rogue One. John, pay attention.
How many times do I have to repeat myself? This is like the third time.
Okay.
But I thought Tom's was Rogue One.
No, mine's was just the entire the original three Star Wars movies.
But Tom,
that's
like,
cheating.
That's cheating.
This year.
You were talking about movies this year.
I did see that movies this year.
Yeah, but like they had
like,
to have come out this
new
year.
New movies this year.
Then why did I say Lupin animes that came out this or that I watched
we don't,
this year?
I don't know. Why did you? I mean, did you miss the topic of like a year recap? Like we were saying, it was like, oh, what movies came out or what animes came out this year? What movies came out this year? Tom, you need to catch up with us.
Yeah, but it's in general. I mean, it's our year recap. It's our year recap.
It's a new book.
Our year. You're on a different book. That's what I watched this year.
Okay, fine.
But I specifically said at the beginning of it, movies that came out this year.
I didn't.
I did. I'll I'll take the clip. I will copy pasta. Here we go. There, I said it. Right there.
Okay, so John, what was your worst movie?
Ain't the trifecta, kiddo.
Ooh.
Sausage Party is definitely one of them.
No, you know what? No, I actually found Sausage Party to be more enjoyable than these three fucking shitty movies.
No.
It would be a quad. It would be quad, but I didn't see this movie. The three worst movies of this year are going to be Suicide Squad, Batman v Superman, and Ghostbusters.
Oh.
Those three movies can go fuck themselves. They were flaming dog turds.
You saw these movies?
Huh?
Did you see these movies?
Yes, I saw all three of them.
Okay.
All three of these movies are flaming dog turds that deserve to be eaten by the SJW community. I said it. There you go.
Oh. Ooh, you said the word SJW. So edgy.
Yes, these movies were terrible. Suicide Squad, because it was just terrible. I don't have any words because of bad direction in general.
Batman v Superman. Jared Leto.
No, it didn't need Jared Leto. It just needed a better story and better direction. Batman v Superman was just exposition in the movie.
And of course, Superman is Jesus.
And of course, the Waynes died again.
Oh, Master Wayne.
Master Wayne.
Okay, now the Alfred was good.
But was it Michael Caine?
No, it wasn't Michael Caine. It was Jeremy Irons, though. So it was Scar.
It wasn't Michael Caine.
Michael Caine's best Batman.
Michael Caine for Batman.
I'm Batman.
I've become the Batman. Master Wayne.
And then Batman.
Just because that movie was just a flaming fucking mess. Because when your movie revolves around building character tropes, not characters themselves, you know you have a terrible movie.
I mean, it was also directed by that one guy, so.
When your movie is focusing on developing the feminist idea that the ladies are powerful because they have they're quippy and they're slightly lesbian, it's not a good movie.
Wait, what movie are we talking about?
Ghostbusters.
That movie was terrible.
I thought you were talking about Suicide Squad.
I thought you were talking about Batman versus Superman. I was like, wait, there were lesbians in Batman? Are we talking about Wonder Woman here? Is that a stab?
And that's not something like, yeah, if Wonder Woman's a little bit lesbian, I mean, like, not a problem. That makes sense.
I mean,
Wonder Woman can be a lesbian. It's fine.
Yeah,
she grew up with only women.
Yeah, but Ghostbusters is like, oh, they are not so slight, but we're saying they're slight lesbian undertones. But this movie's not about lesbians. Ha ha ha. Fuck that.
And the black chick is super black.
And black chick is black. She's woolly. She's woolly.
It's not like woolly black. Nope.
Ryan, don't feed him. Don't feed him.
Yes, feed me more.
Don't feed John. People. Don't pop the pig.
Oh, fuck you! Don't pop the puss.
John, you're like a comedian that's bombing, and then like they tap the mic. Is this thing on? God damn it.
Is this thing on?
But runner up for worst movie was gotta be Sasha's Party.
Yeah, that was terrible.
Sasha's Party.
Sasha's Party.
Sasha's Party doesn't sound so bad.
Rogan.
Sausage Party. Yeah, no.
That was last year's meme, John.
Let me look into my mirror and just say it. Seth Rogen.
Yeah, that movie was just bad.
Seth Rogen?
Yeah, Seth Rogen the movie is bad.
Oh.
Pineapple Express
was a good one.
Pineapple League.
That was the first one.
That's my favorite DLC for League of Legends.
Yep.
the League of Extraordinary Pineapple.
Oh, and then Zack and Miri Make a Porno is Seth Rogen the movie part 2.
You know what? I gotta make a comment. My favorite movie this year was the BFG, The Big Fucking Gun by Disney.
Yeah, fucking Doom.
I wanted to see that because I loved that book.
Was that good?
Yeah, hey, Doom hold is a good on. Game, man.
Hold on, John. You don't watch any Disney. What is this bullshit?
He doesn't watch classic Disney.
No, I don't watch Disney in general, but I just found it hilarious that they released a movie called the BFG, and I was like,
John's an asshole.
This is the big fucking gun.
Yeah, no, everyone on Tumblr was like, it's actually a book. It's not, no, it's the big fucking gun. What are you talking about?
It's the big fucking gun.
Come on. Big fucking gun.
Come on, guys. Okay. Come on.
What are we jumping on to next?
Video game? Ethan Klein face. Well, yeah. So since we can't fucking do games we played this year, since that's a rule, I guess.
We can do games we played this year.
Then why can't I do movies I watched this year? Anyways.
We meant games that came out this year that you played.
That's a dumb kind of stipulation, but okay.
No, it's not. That's the point. Oh my god, Tom.
If
just
you're
say Watch Dogs
like a...
2 and get it over with.
No, because that's not.
That's not the best game of 2016 that you played.
I mean, it's one of them.
But Tom, I'm in.
I played 100 and something hours of
I'm
Stardew
in,
Valley
but
this
Tom,
year.
I'm in. Stardew Valley came out.
Yeah, came out this year.
What?
Yeah, came out this year.
Oh, I can't. But, it had to have came out last year.
It came out this year.
Right, wow.
Yeah.
It came out so early this year, it felt like last year, I guess.
You've been wrong twice this podcast. Stop.
Hey.
There's also
you've
Firewatch.
Been wrong like all the, every time.
Firewatch that came out this year. It was a good game. I played. Okay. Guess
but
that's what I'm
one
limited
was your
to then.
Favorite?
I guess since I can't pick games that I played this year. Except for the current ones. Let's see. Darkest Dungeon was good too that I played this year.
I guess that counts.
Darkest Dungeon came out this year.
That technically counts, even though it was in early access for like 2 years.
Early access games don't count.
Fuck everything.
Early access games don't count.
Oh.
Dark Souls wasn't my thing for this year.
It's my thing. That's my pick. Dark Souls 3 is my game of the year. Let's see.
Dark Souls 3.
In fact, I just beat Dark Souls 3 last night or yesterday afternoon.
So I guess I'll say Stardew Valley.
Good choice. Cuz
I had a lot of fun with that.
Stardew Valley's legit.
But I did play more games than that. I guess I'll save that for never.
Okay. Tori, any games that came out this year that you liked?
You're barking up the wrong tree here, man.
Mobile games count.
Okay, fine then. Oh, Mystic Messenger. Yeah.
Of course it's Mystic Messenger. It's the only game you played this. Well, unless you count that stupid Marvel dating sim.
Yeah, I'm like, you don't want to hear about
that,
Avengers.
And that's,
I mean,
that good, though.
You don't, Enter the Gungeon came out this year, and that was really disappointing.
That's a ball buster, though. All the events to get characters, like... I don't think I'm going to be able to get the female Loki, because I have Loki, but now you can get the female skin. I know that sounds really weird, but like you can get different outfits from Janet Van Dyne's, you know, costume shop.
Mm-hmm.
I got...
Tori,
I did get...
one of us needs to get you a video game console so you can play some good games.
No, please don't do that to me.
We'll get you a PS TV and get you a bunch of visual novels.
Well, you can, Tori, get The World Ends With You. It's on mobile phones. It's actually a really good port of it.
The World Ends With You is on mobile?
Yeah, it's $17, but I mean, it's worth it.
Oh,
it's really
come on.
You'll have like hundreds of hours in that.
That game is super good. Is it still the weird mechanic that it had on the DS?
It has that weird tapping mechanic, but it's a lot better because you only have one screen instead of two.
Yeah, it was so fucking bizarre because it had two screens that you had to pay attention to both screens at the same time during combat. It was so fucking bizarre.
I mean, that's what stopped me from playing it the first time around. And then when it got released on mobile, I think 2 years ago, that's when I played it. And it's really good. I mean, it's still really good. I would recommend that you play that, Tori. It would be right up your alley. It's weird Square Enix characters and weird, like, kind of edgy characters. It's really good.
I've never actually played one of the Square Enix games. Like, I didn't even play Kingdom. Okay, here's the thing. Here's why I didn't get into video games as a child.
Go on.
I did not have a console of my own until I was like 9 or 10. That's when we got our GameCube. And we got Mario Party for that. Before that, every time I tried to play one of my cousin's games, like they were normally guy cousins, I would always go over to the house. And as soon as I try to play, they're like, no, I have to show you how to play it. And basically just made me,
sit there. Slap him with your...
Because I was not an aggressive child.
Slapping with your shoe.
With your milkies.
No. Chancla.
Here's the thing. I didn't know the chancla was a thing until I was, like, an older child. Because that wasn't something that my grandmother used on me.
No party hard came out this year, later. You know what, Tori? You know what? Here's what we'll do. We'll get you...
That's the way. Don't really like Let's Plays. Okay, I would like some Let's Plays. If I want to know how the game goes, I'll watch the Let's Play.
I mean, that's
fine. I already have a history of just watching guys play the game in front of me. And I mean, no.
The stuff that I started watching was like Chugga Conroy.
Oh, I remember Chugga Conroy.
Chugga Conroy, he's still chugging. Xenoblade will get found.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Last time I saw him, he was doing like the first Xenoblade Chronicles.
Yeah, I mean, he's still on that.
He's still... No, he's not still on Xenoblade.
Well, I mean, he's still on a Xeno game.
Oh, is he doing X?
I think he is. I think he's doing Xeno Chronicles. Fuck, one of Xeno games.
I was really into it when he... Because I was playing Okami, and he did his Okami playthrough at the same time. So I just watched like how he did it.
That's always fun to do.
Yeah.
You should play Okami.
Even if I do get a game system, like, you know, a GameCube, or I bought my own Nintendo DS.
No, here's what we do.
I just get a whole bunch of nerdy games, like Brain Academy.
We could just get you a Steam account. I mean, just there's a lot of games that
she doesn't have a computer that can play.
No, there's a lot of games on there that are really good and that really.
We get her a PlayStation 2 and get her Persona 4. Done.
Yeah, but do you really want to start at the top?
Want her to start with Persona 3?
Persona is like the thickest book to get through at the beginning.
Look, if we're gonna start her off with Persona 3 instead, we got to get her the PSP version.
But I mean, not. I would say stick with The World Ends With You. Like, play that first, and if you like it, like, because JRPGs, especially Atlas JRPGs, are like. You have to be really into JRPGs. Oh, that's what came out this year that I played. Sharp FE, Summer Lesson. God damn it, that Atlas game that came out for the Wii U.
The fucking like,
that Fire Emblem one, Fire Emblem Across Shin Megami Tensei.
Oh, that came out this year.
It's another name. Tokyo Mirage Sessions. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was an alright game. It was very stylish. Did it come out? No, yeah, it was Japan's release. Do yourself a favor and play that game, guys, because that's a really stylish, fun game, and it will give you an insight to what Persona 5 might be like.
Tokyo Mirage?
Yeah.
Played it. It's really good.
But boy, it has that same Atlas problem of like, hey, we're going to front-load everything with you information.
It's a lot of fucking bulk. Like, there's a lot to that game.
Yeah.
I found it kind of unenjoyable at first until I actually started getting into it.
I mean, it's the same thing I had with Persona 4 when I was younger. I kept stopping and starting that game up because I was like, man, am I going to play a game? You know, it's not until like the second or third week of that game you start getting into it. Like, wow. And that's like 10 hours, five hours in. It's a lot.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, so, John, what was your top game?
Wait, did Ryan already say his?
Is Dark Souls, right?
Dark Souls 3.
Dark Souls 3?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to abstain at Firewatch and Stardew Valley because those are really good indie games that came out this year. I haven't played Owlboy yet, but I would have chose Owlboy if I would have played it this year. But meh.
Okay, question. Does an expansion count?
No.
Yes. God damn it. It came out this year.
It depends. Is it like expansion, or is it DLC?
Like Witcher? Are we talking like Witcher 3, the Dark Hunt shit, whatever it's called?
Are we talking about like Blood and Wine Witcher 3 DLC, which is just the same engine but like slightly new stuff? Or are we talking like World of Warcraft Legion, where it completely changes the game?
I'm talking Destiny Rise of Iron, where it added.
No, doesn't count.
I mean,
it does count.
It's a DLC of a shooting game. It doesn't change anything. Do you still point and shoot, and our boss is still bullet sponges? The answer is yes.
you bastard! You just ruined my own game.
Pick something else. DLC account.
What else did you play?
Eyes of Heaven was pretty bad.
It was a good side story.
It could have been, but the gameplay was ass.
I will say that just read the visual novel.
Yeah.
Or just read the, sorry, light novel.
You like that One Piece.
Burning Blood.
Burning Blood was okay.
No, One Piece Pirate Warriors 3.
Oh. That was last year's game.
Was that last year?
Yeah, it was late last year.
Oh, shit. I'm just terrible at keeping track of time.
You struck out three times. You're
I'm like zero out of three right now. Jesus fuck.
You know what? I'm gonna give it to Overwatch.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's kind of a given for me too. I didn't say it.
For me, it's a fun game. I can pick it up and play anytime I want to. And yeah, everything else this year is kind of shitty. So.
I mean, like, there's a lot of good shit that came out this year, though, man.
Like Civ 6, Watch Dogs 2.
I haven't
Final Fantasy 15.
Final Fantasy 15.
Okay. The Witness. Oh, God. I really wanted to like The Witness. Super Hot came out this year. That's a fucking dope-ass game.
Let's just take a time out really
quick. General Jousting.
Yep.
Total War Warhammer.
Hold up. Time out.
Clash of Clans came out this year too, and that's a pretty good mobile game.
Clash of Clans came out this year?
Yeah. Oh, sorry, Clash Royale, my bad.
Clash Royale.
Yeah. It's actually a really good game. They have tournaments for it.
Did it came out this year?
Pokemon Sun and Moon, John, not your thing?
It's another Pokemon game though.
No, yeah. it's not my top game of the year.
Okay.
Technically, it did come out this year on January 4th, so it's technically. Yep.
Clash of Clans. Yep.
Oh,
Clash Royale. Sorry.
I do want to make a point that Final Fantasy 15 would be my game of the year if the game was complete.
Yeah, they did add a bunch of stuff to it, but it's still a good game.
What, 15?
It's a good game. 15. It's not a complete game.
Well, I kind of wish. It's a complete game. It just has like.
Having
10 years of different developers and different in like changes to the story.
Right.
But but they announced that they're going to fix like the one chapter that's terrible.
I just want I want King's Glaive to be like a mention in a like a flyer someone gives you. You know, not a flyer, but like you can just read up on it if you want
to. How far are you in Final Fantasy 15?
I'm like 2 hours in.
Yeah, keep playing.
Keep
playing, you'll find out.
I'm just saying that like I never liked that whole, it's the same problem I have with Destiny. I hated that go to the website and you'll fucking watch this.
Keep playing, you'll find out.
Okay, I understand that, but I mean, it's the basis of it is that's still a terrible way to market your game, is that you have to watch this movie in order
to. You don't really have to though, but keep playing and you'll find out.
The most disappointing game for me is Last Guardian.
Worst game?
Disappointing. I wouldn't say worst.
I mean,
worst has to be back in 1995 for me.
You know what the worst one was?
Now, is this limited to games that we've played?
I've played Last Guardian.
I'd had to have played it.
No Man's Sky, because fucking that's obvious. And Mighty No. 9 is fucking obvious as well.
Look, my two votes are going to go to Mighty No. 9 being the worst and followed up by No Man's Sky because I played both.
That's...
The Last Guardian wasn't bad, but it wasn't as fun.
It was disappointing. Now, if we're talking just straight shit, yes, Mighty No. 9, No Man's Sky, and to an extent, Street Fighter V.
I'll fight you on that one. Why Street Fighter V?
Street Fighter V is literally like what you're complaining about with Final Fantasy 15. It is an incomplete game at launch. The characters, everything else like that. Like when I play Street Fighter, there's a certain kind of thing that you expect, and like I realize that the core thing that they were focusing on is like here are the characters, here is the online mode, go. I didn't like that. I'm not into Street Fighter like I used to be. Like I kind of want to play some online matches, but at launch I didn't see worth paying $60 for this game. And Alex wasn't in it, even though they had teased Alex for like a long time.
You know what? I'll give you that. The game at launch was terrible, but for what it is right now, it's not bad.
I mean, right now, yeah. Like as of fucking January 1st. Yeah, it's an okay game, and the promise that they're bringing like five completely new characters is pretty cool. But at launch, it was disappointing, and it was
at launch it was bad. At launch, it was a bad game. But I'll say it's kind of like, you know what? It's kind of like the Destiny game where it's supposed to have like a program. We're supposed to have a year program, a several year program where it's gonna get better over the years.
I mean, like, I never got that, like, games like that, and this is probably why I don't play a lot of early access games because of this reason, and it's the same reason why I didn't like No Man's Sky as well. It's because, like, yeah, we'll have more guys, but, like, that $60 buy never got me for either of these games because it's like, why am I going to pay $60 for a game that's incomplete when I could not pay anything and get stuff like Killer Instinct, which is a free game if you have a X-Bone, and you can buy characters if you want, and they're constantly updating that game, versus Street Fighter, where they had to put a patch of story in, they had to patch, you know, a bunch of other shit, arcade mode. It's just like again, at launch, Killer Instinct had a story mode. It had a bunch of characters that you can mess around with, free characters every week. You know, it just beats it in all, you know, fields of it for a fighting game. Good fighting game this year is KOF. I will have to say that. I will fight anyone. KOF was really good. I didn't like the graphics, but the graphics update that they recently did is like, holy shit.
It's a good game. It's not my favorite. I go Street Fighter V is my favorite.
I mean, it's Street Fighter. It's a good fucking game. It's going to play good. You know, and it's introducing a lot of stuff to the casual market. Like a lot of the frame links aren't that really tight. And it's just a little bit more looser.
I take that back as my favorite fighter. Best fighter this year was Guilty Gear.
Okay. Okay. I'll sort of agree with you on that.
Okay.
Nitro Plus Blasters, though. No, I'm just kidding. It's a really good fighting game, but it's really anime.
I'm actually, like, having a hard time, like, figuring out what's the most disappointing game I played. Because, like, if it's, like, most disappointing game in general that I didn't have to have played, like that'd be like easy, but like then you limit me to like I actually have to play it, and which is hard because I always look into various games and like look into like people that like whose opinions I trust, like it's like, oh, if he doesn't think it's that great, I'll take his word for it, and like I'll avoid it. But so I'm just looking around. I can think of two. Mm. Right now I need to find this one. When was this released? Oh no, this came out last year, so it doesn't count. Third of last year. So honestly, like the game that I played this year that I'm disappointed in would be God Eater 2.
Because it's just Monster Hunter.
It's a lame Monster Hunter.
Yeah.
God Eater 1 is good.
It's God Eater 2 is just Monster Hunter, but with less feeling, less characters, like less feeling behind like the weapons that you have, and like especially if you played Monster Hunter Generations, they added a slightly new thing, visual thing that adds like so much more feeling into each swing of your weapon, and they added like swooshes to your weapon, like swoosh lines. And I played Monster Hunter Generations for the first time today with some friends, and then I noticed that when you have like the long sword, it's like a thin line, and it's like it feels like you're surgically cutting the air around you, and when you have a great sword, it's like whoosh, like big whoosh lines, and it feels like you're, and it adds that extra bit of feeling to your to your swings, like you can feel the swings behind it. and this I'm like standing in God Eater 2, I'm like standing there with a giant fucking cannon, and I go, and there's no like your character recoiling, or there's none of that. You just like girf, your gun like shifts back in your arms, and you're just standing there like it's like you just got pushed by a 4-year-old, like eh. And there's no feeling in it. And there's also I don't know. It's just, I didn't care for it.
All right.
That is, but the game that I was talking about that I had to check if it came out this year, I was actually going to choose Trading Quest Heroes. But they came out December 2nd of last year, so I can't choose it.
You know what? As far as disappointing too, I'll say my Dragon Quest game and Dragon Quest Builders.
Dragon Quest Builders?
I really wish it's fucking fantastic. I love it. But it's disappointing on the sense of every time that so in the game it's basically Minecraft with Dragon Quest. I'm not gonna like fucking pussyfoot around that. But it's good because you do your missions and then you collect your ores and you smelt, you do all that stuff. And the whole purpose is that you're trying to build a city and you fill it with people, you build your shops, you do all kinds of shit, like a Dragon Quest town. And the cool thing about it too, story-wise, I didn't know about this, is that in the end of Dragon Quest 1, so this is like a sequel to Dragon Quest 1. And I was like, what the fuck? Are you kidding me? Because in Dragon Quest 1, you can either choose to be evil or good. And this goes to the evil side. And even so, where you see, I forget the fucking main hero's name, character one, Eldin, Eldritch, or something like that. Someone will correct me. Okay. Shut up, drunk. It shows him like in a tomb. He's been sealed up because he's evil, you know. And people of the land forgot how to build towns. And that's the story reason why. And it's really cool. And it's just like you have to build your town, protect your city from goblins. The shitty thing is that after you finish a certain amount of missions, that town that you built so much and spent so much time in, just say fuck it and leave. And it's like, fuck what? And all the stuff that you built, if you have a pickaxe that you had, if you had a bunch of stuff, wood that you collected, like a lot of gravel, whatever that you collected, it's just gone when you leave. And you have to literally start from like zero at the next town. And that sucks because I really love the world building of it. And I love a fucking the Akira Toriyama-esque art style of it. So, you know, it's cool, but it's really disappointing. And that fucking hour long tutorial that you have to do at the beginning. Oh boy, is it rough. That's a really bad one for me. But also back in 1995 is also a really bad one for me. Because I love survival horror games, and I think a lot of us do. Silent Hill 2 is my favorite survival horror game of all time. But back in 1995, pays homage to not only Silent Hill, but Resident Evil, and stuff like Haunting Ground as well. Not Haunting Ground, but the original PS1 horror games. Survival horror games. And it does it so bad and so piss poorly that I didn't even get more than an hour in. And I was just like, man, this is just shit. I really hate this. It doesn't do a send up right. It doesn't do a send up into the fake, you know, Silent Hill-esque music. And it's just, it almost feels like a dollar store Silent Hill. And I wanted to love this game more than that. I wanted it to be like, well, you know, I wanted this to be the Shovel Knight of survival horror. You know what I mean? But it just didn't live up to that standard for me. So Dragon Quest Builders and back in 1995 are top for me as well as disappointing. But that's just me talking to myself right now, I guess.
No, I'm listening.
No, I mean, I guess, whatever.
So what else do we got for this year?
I guess three good things that happened to us. So let's start with John.
Three good things that happened to us?
Yeah, yes.
Fuck. San Japan.
That was good. Panel was great. We got to see Ryan for the first time.
Yeah.
Me graduating.
Yeah.
And Mulligan a third, because I don't have a third.
You can finally experience what it feels like. Yeah, there you go. Nope, that's it. John experienced tranquility. Tori? What about your favorite moments of this? I mean, your good things that happened to you this year.
Okay, well, I already mentioned one, and that was meeting the Punisher.
Yeah.
But I could put all of Alamo City Comic Con, because I also got to meet Daredevil. I just didn't party with him, but he was really nice. So Alamo City Comic Con was one. And I got a job. My first job ever. Yeah. Job. So that was great. And then third one, that's kind of iffy because that not a lot stuck out as big as those two things.
Sandrapan.
Yeah, I would say Sandrapan, but like you already said, Sandrapan. And RealmsCon was good this year too. But let's see. Oh, I made serious progress on my fan fictions.
Nice.
So nothing got abandoned. Because that's the hardest thing, to keep going with your writing, and I've kept going, and I haven't stopped.
Yeah, it's always good. Inspired of what you love. Ryan?
Going to Sandrapan, meeting you guys and Fred and Levi and Mike and all them guys. Like,
I mean, not Fred, right?
Of course Fred.
Who?
Like, yeah. I was a big fan of Fred for the longest time before becoming his friend.
Wait, you mean Brental Floss?
Shut up.
Brental Floss.
Brental Floss.
Brental Fred.
Didn't you get a job too this year, Ryan?
Yeah, I got a job, but it wasn't my first job, so it's not that big a deal.
Yeah.
Well, it's a job.
Yeah. Harambe dying was pretty cool.
That was really great. That was, I have to say, you know what? Everyone else is, no, that's...
I mean, like, animals, right?
Yeah, fuck him.
He's totally gonna rip that kid in half.
Yeah.
No.
Yep.
Wait. Oh, yeah, I forgot we can do this if John starts talking about Harambe.
There goes John.
Okay, so...
Never mind. I love you, John.
No. Harambe's death was too powerful for me. It hurt.
And that's about
it. Did it really hurt?
Yeah.
Why you keep making jokes about it?
Okay, here's the thing. I know you live in Brownsville, but did you ever actually go to see him at the zoo?
Yes.
Aside from once.
What?
Aside from once.
Like four times.
John, stop lying.
I'm not.
Disappoint me, John.
Well, like, how old were you the first time you saw him?
Probably like 9.
Oh.
Well, he was in Brownsville until 2014, so, you know.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
So God damn it.
But he's dead. I guess...
Oh. Okay, what else?
I guess...
I mean, the only reason we entertained this joke for so long is because he did actually live in the town that he did.
Yeah, I guess. I guess my favorite moments or the good things that happened to me is, surprisingly, I got laid off from my job because... No, that was a good thing because...
No, I thought, because I heard you say I got laid, and I thought that was going to be the good thing.
That's never happened. Anyways, unless that thing we talked about before the podcast. And anyways.
Daddy's
Dungeon 4.
We'll bring the whips.
John's a big old whore. Anyways. Getting laid off from a shitty job, why is that a good thing? Because... at that time, I wasn't really doing anything, and then Mr. John BlackNapple11 said, "Hey, do you want to come on this podcast with my buddies?" And I said, "Sure, I'll be on there," and that's when I joined. So joining this podcast last year was it's really good. It's basically one of my big moments, and then doing Sandrapan panel with you guys.
At least you got invited to be a member. I was just supposed to be a guest, and I never left.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You were just in the Skype call the whole time.
Yeah, that was pretty much it. Like,
you guys got invited. I was just like, "Hey, John, can I join?" And he's like, "Okay."
Hey, Ryan, you want to be a member?
Sure.
Okay, you're a member now.
Awesome. Oh my god, yes, finally, it's official.
Now he's only been doing HR for like
couple months, editing for the last year.
Well, it's official.
Put it on your Facebook, Wiki, LinkedIn. But yeah, that was that. It's really, really meeting you guys and having fun on this podcast. Episodes later, I love you guys.
Also,
Sandrapan. Also, I got a job. So.
Woo!
Yeah.
You got a job.
Yeah.
Chick-chick-chick-chick.
Yeah. That was our. Well, 2016. Oh, God. I guess this is the time. John, what's yours?
Oh, what the fuck? Why do I go first?
Because you're the leader. You're the leader of the crew. You know him well. You're gonna kick some tail.
Am I the big boss?
Yes.
Yes. I call Venom.
Fuck you. Don't, okay, give me. I'll be big boss.
I like that big old horn. Yeah, you can be Ocelot. You have to be the cat thing. You have to do the cat thing.
And Tori can be.
No, what? You're walking on thin ice.
Sniper Wolf. On thin ice. Eva, quiet.
Let me be Eva. No, yeah, quiet. Sure. I'm gonna be quiet.
Okay.
Because she actually has brown hair, and I like.
Tori, you can't be quiet.
That is okay. No, rude. It's possible for me to be quiet.
Rude.
Uh huh. Prove that you can be quiet.
She did it. Damn, John. That shade. Damn, it got darker in here, Tori, because all that shade John was throwing.
See, I like working on that pun. That's why I said it.
You know what? Fuck it. I want to be Miller instead. I like being a huge asshole.
You want to be Cuz?
Yeah, Cuz.
I just like a goddamn fiddle.
Oh, wait, darn it. What's the name? Cuz, okay, no one ever told me that this character has existed before, but apparently there's this, like, little gay slave boy to one of the villains.
What?
Oh,
what?
Oh, that's fucking the Raiden lookalike for in Metal Gear Solid 3.
God damn it, Rajanovich, something like that.
Hold on.
God damn, I think
like,
it was.
Why didn't anyone tell me about this before? Funny. Like his boss just randomly grabs his crotch, and I was like, "Are you lying to me? Is this some fan thing?" And she goes, "No, it's not a fan thing." That. Rykov, yes. Oh, yeah. Why didn't anyone tell me about this?
MGS3 was a weird fucking game.
MGS3 was my favorite.
Oh my god.
And you guys told me none of this. You guys are trying to get me to play video games, and none of you thought to bring this up.
Then fucking play Final Fantasy 15. That literally has the most.
Yeah, that's
literally like, the most hard gay.
It's a bunch of. It has everything. It's like, yeah. It's gay, it's straight. The only thing it's missing is furries.
Yeah,
that sounds good to me because I don't
get a PS4, buy a used one. They're probably not that expensive nowadays.
They're probably not that expensive anymore. Yeah,
Neo, since the Neo's out and all,
the Pro, you mean?
I like Neo better. It makes it sound stupid. Look, I'm also that idiot who likes the Sega Katana better than the Dreamcast.
What?
That's what the original name for the Dreamcast was.
Fred doesn't
Sega
even
Katana.
Call it the Katana. So it's not called the Katana.
How much do you want? Sega Katana.
Dude, if Fred doesn't call it the Katana, then it's not called the Katana.
And yeah, Fred's but like, Fred also.
Fred's like the biggest fucking.
Are you sure?
Dreamcast. Yeah, I'm fairly certain.
Does he have like 80 yes. Dreamcast games like I do?
Yes, he does. Actually, I've seen his collection. He does. Okay. He has all the Dreamcast games.
Oh, boy.
I'm not even joking.
Well, Fred's also, like, 900 years older than me.
Wow. Fred is the oldest person that we know. Wait, no. Ryan. Fuck.
No, that's Brian. Brian's the oldest guy we know.
Yeah.
That guy's fucking ancient.
And Ryan's the oldest.
Yeah, he's like,
podcast.
Remember? Because he used to watch my children's cartoons, like the ones I watched when I was 6, and he watched them as an adult, ironically. Not ironically.
He wasn't an adult. He was like a teenager.
He was like 40-something when he was in the 80s, right? Yep. He's basically a fossil now.
Yep. Yeah, we could probably, like, you know, get some good fossil fuels out of him.
So, what were we talking about?
Favorite moments. How much I love you guys. How much Tori needs to play video games?
Resolutions.
Oh yeah, resolutions. We're starting with you, John.
Then
we started talking about the boss, and then we started talking about the Sega Katana.
You guys are fucking weebs.
Yeah, Katana means Japanese sword in Japanese.
You're right.
Did you know the Japanese flag is a representation of how much Japan is Japan?
Yeah.
Yes. That's
true.
I've seen that Tumblr post.
That's true.
I've seen those hot maymays.
Them spicy memes.
Those spicy memes.
Best fucking emote. That fucking suck emote. Thank you. A random anime group that decided to add me for showing me that. That little thing. Oof. It's
also
been my favorite thing.
Shout out to our
which one is this?
The little this thing. Hold on. This guy.
By the way, shout out to our artist, our new artist who is making the Tom Kui.
Oh yeah. We never showed the general public. I'll post Kui tonight.
No. Don't post Kui. Just keep.
Or I'll put that zoom in face and it's just put.
Did
like
we ever get the fucking new logo yet?
Rachel's in Canada right now, so she can't send it to me.
She can.
Why not?
Because she doesn't have her computer with her.
I thought we got a thing of it.
We did, but I never got the right sizes because I sent her the wrong measurements. So she sent me the wrong.
Of course, she sent her.
I sent her the wrong sizes, and then she needed to retouch something really quick, and then it's a long story.
Retouch, anyways.
That being said, resolutions for this year are for me to be more. Resolutions for this year are for me to be more forward with people and more assertive.
Yeah, John. Fuck you.
Fuck you, Tom. You're fired.
There you go. See.
All right. There you go. That's the spirit.
Fuck you, Tori. You're fired too.
Not be insertive. Anyways. Oh.
Be insertive. Tori, come here.
Oh. Speaking of Tori.
I'm on a bus right now.
What?
What's your resolution, Tori? Jesus.
Oh, God.
It's escalated quickly.
Is that an HR?
Yeah, it is.
A little more. But my resolution is to actually get into medical school for the next year because I didn't make it this cycle. It's fine. I just need to get a higher MCAT score, so it means more studying.
Cool.
Okay.
Rianne?
I don't know.
Okay.
I suck at making resolutions. I often forget them.
His goal is to not be as white.
That's gonna be hard.
Hey, I'm already black. Someone thought I was Latino at one point in my life, and
what?
I've been dubbed an honorary black man. So I think I'm going on the right track.
Yeah. Ryan, your goal for this year should be to be the most Mexican white person in Wisconsin.
Yeah, for some reason my friend keeps on mistaking like Mexican actors for Asians. And also, people mistake my sister and my mother for Asian all the time.
So last week, me and John were talking and. It was the night or the day after he saw Rogue One.
And he thought Cassian was Asian, didn't he?
No. He totally thought that fucking, what's his name?
Diego Luna.
He thought he was French too. So I'm not the only one.
What? But you saw Book of Life.
That fucking accent was everywhere, Tori. He was like, hello, my name is Captain Amador and I like the women, but I actually have parental issues.
Dude, right? He didn't sound any different.
He sounded just like Jean-Claude Van Damme. Sounded just like Jean-Claude Van Damme.
No, he looks okay. I was going to say something, but I better not say that.
Say it.
No.
Say it.
No.
Do it.
He actually looks like my mechanic, so he's Mexican, dude.
Oh.
I mean, you're Mexican. You can say that.
That's true. Okay. Well, yeah, he does look like a dirty.
Yeah, man, the mechanics are Mexican. You know, also the cops are Mexican. The lawyers are Mexican. The doctor, everyone's Mexican.
The Mexican is Mexican.
Everyone's Mexican.
The Mexicans are Mexican. No, the Mexicans are white.
Everyone. That's the title of this episode. Everyone is Mexican.
That sounds Mexican.
Except for Silver Fist.
The Three Fists podcast.
It'd be more like the 3/4 podcast.
No, it's called
the Donald Duck of the Three Amigos because he's white, and the other two were actually Latinos.
That was an alright movie. The Three Amigos.
It was one of my favorites. I used to watch that all the time. I like the Three Amigos, especially the parrot Jose.
Oh, my New Year's resolution
is to be more racist.
To get a girlfriend. I don't know.
Same.
Tori.
What?
She
already
said hers.
Don't look. Okay.
Oh,
it's not making things awkward.
That
got to
happen
here.
Sometime. I guess mine's is gonna be. I'm trying to go vegetarian because red meat is. I eat too much red meat.
Vegetarian.
Yeah, sure.
How do you eat too much red meat?
Dude, I eat a lot of beef. Like.
So do I.
But I go excessive. It's like, we're not getting into this. Anyways,
Thomas.
Also, to be more green, to be more eco-friendly this year.
Okay, that's a good resolution.
I've already stopped using paper plates since like last year, but this year I'm gonna go hardcore on like conserving water and doing a bunch of stuff like that. So
This only adds to the persona of Tom Hipstar.
Yeah, it does, but fuck it. I don't give a shit.
That would be Tom Hipstar. Funny. I already fucking
wear flannel. It's like 90%
the next time
of my life.
We see him, he's gonna have like a beard and a beanie. We're gonna confuse him for a homeless man, but he's still Tom.
You're talking to a 19-year-old Tom. He used to wear a beanie all fucking days.
Yeah.
Oh, gee.
Yeah. But this time he'll have a beard and like them thick rimmed glasses.
Have you seen my new glasses?
Oh. Okay, well, I don't mind the thick rimmed glasses as much as the 70s pedophile glasses.
And like the only thing you'll drink is like fucking. Oh, wait, no, I have seen your glasses. They're fucking hipster glasses. Totally. Yeah.
I listen to stupid music that nobody else listens to.
Look, if you're gonna be hipster, I say, oh my god, it's already happened.
We're just own it. Oh my god, I guess. Tom's a hipster.
I only drink craft beer when I do drink. So
fucking craft beer. Stop. He's gonna recommend fucking avant-garde movies that are fucking so like. Oh, I've only seen this at fucking Sundance.
I've only seen movies
from
the 80s.
You'll only see this at Sundance Festival.
You know what? Hey, Ryan.
What?
You want to know what's funny?
You
right
know.
Down the street from my house, there's a Sundance Theater.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's cool. Because, okay, the Sundance Theater is a good place.
It's actually really good to watch some movies.
To watch the more independent movies. Like, here we have the Bijou. Basically, those movies that they say, oh, only a limited release.
Yeah.
We ain't got that shit up here by me.
I mean, you have the cow projecting the movie, so made of cheese.
Oh.
Yeah.
Shut up there.
I'm trying to watch Rogue One.
Stop ruining the movie.
Dumbledore dies at the end.
Save Cruel Dumbledore.
Stop milking it.
I think we can call this an episode.
And everybody listening to this podcast, thank you for your continued listening for the new this year.
Let's make the Communicast really great again this year.
Sticking with us. Thank you for accepting me, everyone. I really appreciate that. This has been like, I think one of the best things that I've been a part of, and I've been a part of some stupid shit. But this is the stupid shit. But I at least have cool people to talk to. Boy.
You think I'm cool?
Yeah.
Let's make. Good one, everybody listening. I don't know. Post your New Year's resolution down below.
Yeah.
And let's make this year the year of the butt sex. On that note, everybody, good night.
If there's any eligible bachelorettes out there, you can email me. You know, just list your, just give me your contacts in the comment below.
Put your measurements.
You know, I'm not that picky, Tori.
I know.
Look, if you like hearing me ramble about dumb shit no one fucking cares about, please. Please, I need someone to talk to throughout the day. This is the only day I get to geek out.
Good night, everyone.
I'm desperate, please.
Night. Happy New Year. Happy
I drink craft beer, goddammit.
Let's make 2017 a good one.
Guys, this band I listen to is only online, and you can listen to it on cassette tape. You know what? I'm not ashamed to say it. I bought a Vaporwave album on cassette tape. It's pretty good.
Good night, everyone.
I mean, when you come down to San Antonio, you should come to this little cafe, Halcyon. It is the most hipster thing.
Good night, everyone.
We'll do it.